Live, the news you count on. NBC2 News at 5:30.
Naples is taking action to avoid blue-green algae and red tide issues, and their plan could affect how you take care of your lawn. City Council members will vote to ban fertilizers on some days this summer.
But there's still a couple of hurdles to get over before it goes into effect. NBC2's Edna Ruiz is live from City Hall with more on what City Council is considering. Edna.
Yeah, well, for months, people have been pushing the city to go back to a stricter fertilizer ordinance. They say that during the heavy rain season, toxins and nutrients from those fertilizers are being pushed into our waterways. But others think that banning fertilizer for a few months just isn't necessary.
Our goal, though, is to point to policy that's based on evidence, not on the conventional wisdom.
Mark Caraway spoke on behalf of the Environmental Research and Education Foundation. He believes there isn't enough research that shows fertilizer is actually causing harm to our water.
We feel that the science does not support those blackouts. They're not supported by the Florida Department of Environmental Protection, Florida Department of Agriculture.
Caraway says a fertilizer ban from June to September would actually cause more harm.
It takes away 120 days of application potential during the growing season for the plants. So here's the formula. Let's starve plants when they're feeding the most, and let's feed them when they're near dormancy.
But people, including Nicole Johnson, believe a tough fertilizer ordinance would help prevent water quality issues like algae blooms.
If we can't predict how much it's going to rain, we can't predict that the day we decide to fertilize our lawns, that we're not going to have a significant rain event to where all of that fertilizer isn't immediately washed into our waterways.
So she says banning phosphorus and nitrogen-based fertilizers during the summer is the best route to go.
Including a rainy season ban is really key, is really essential. Again, it isn't going to solve all the problems, but it's one easy to implement, easy to enforce, and cost-effective way to ensure that we're not contributing to water quality problems.
This afternoon, the City Council unanimously agreed to move forward with this fertilizer ordinance that includes that ban. But before anything is set in stone, they have to revisit it at a second reading, which is June 5th. Reporting live in Naples, Edna Ruiz, NBC2.
The City of Sanibel is